This is a podcast from the Nuffield Department of Medicine. Dr. Trudie Lang tells us how the Global Health Network facilitates collaboration and resource sharing.
Hello, Trudie.
Hi, Anna.
What is the Global Health Network?
The Global Health Network is a vehicle for helping researchers in developing countries do more and better studies. It's a mechanism for providing equity to access to research, really, because there's not nearly enough research in developing countries for a myriad of reasons. And the Global Health Network helps people find each other, work in collaborations. It's also a working space. It's all about sharing knowledge and methods and tools, because we're quite good at sharing data now in research. But unless we share the methods by which we collected that data, we can't really move forward. So for people wanting to do research where there isn't any research yet, it's really helpful for them to find other researchers, collaborate, and also learn from what other people have done. And so if people can share their methods and tools, then it can speed up research, save duplication. And so many things we do in research are actually very, very similar. It doesn't matter if we're working on malaria or tuberculosis or even cancer or diabetes. We use the same methods largely. So if we can share those, we can speed up research in different areas, and especially in developing countries. So that's what it's all about, really.
And what are the issues when setting up clinical trials in developing countries?
Well, there are several, really, Anna. The main ones are obviously around skills and really access to research, because people are fearful of research. They don't really understand it. They see it as this huge, scary thing that they can't possibly engage in because they're a small unit, health unit in the middle of Uganda or somewhere. But actually, we need research in so many different areas, and it can be very straightforward and pragmatic research, such as, I don't know, looking at different hygiene practices in maternal health. So the things that make it difficult are giving people the skills and resources and the confidence and the mandate to engage in research even in the first place, and see it that it can be very straightforward and simple things and just collecting quite simple data often. Then obviously you're working in quite difficult settings a lot of the time, very isolated communities, hard to get to, the laboratories are a long way from the patients quite often. You might be working in areas of conflict or difficulty, and especially in situations like a disease outbreak or emergency situations, the environment can be very challenging. But probably the most significant issues that people most often talk about are the sort of ethical and social difficulties, if you like, of working in very vulnerable populations. And they're vulnerable because obviously there's a huge discrepancy between the wealth of the participants and the wealth of the researchers. Vulnerable because they're illiterate and they live in rural communities, and so we do a lot of work on understanding how to engage with communities, how to explain what research is and make sure they really understand what's being asked of them.
So what are the most important lines of research that have developed over the past 5 or 10 years?
I think a lot of what we're doing with the Global Health Network is about it's about research methodology itself. So what we're about in our group is trying to bring research skills and resources and improve the methods of how research is done in these settings. So we do quite a lot of work on giving people skills and training in how to do research, but also as part of that we're looking at where there are difficulties in putting research in place and where the barriers are, and understanding how things can be made better. But also because we do a lot of clinical trials in these settings, and that's true across the department really, for the whole of tropical medicine in Oxford, there's lots of actual trials that we do, and we try and learn from those. And what we've found in the last few years is what we're doing often is really cutting edge, and we're doing trials very well and very diligently, and we're working to all the international guidelines and regulations, but we're finding very sensible ways of doing these studies. And actually those mechanisms that we use to do research in these settings can be applied just as easily in London or Washington and Paris. So we're trying to share what we learn about our research methodology with other sectors, because it's absolutely essential that clinical research is made more simple, less cumbersome and less expensive across the globe, not just in developing countries.
So why does your line of research matter? Why should we put money into it?
Well, clinical research has definitely gone global, and there's more and more research happening in places like India and China and Africa, which is great, and it brings investment and research skills to those regions. But we need to make sure that the whole spectrum of research is happening. It's not just drug trials and vaccine trials for commercial purposes. Of course that's needed. We also need to do the more pragmatic research that's addressing maybe disease management questions or things like maternal health, malnutrition, not so much commercially viable but very important for disease burdens in those regions.
What are your plans for the future?
We're really trying to engage much more with everybody that's involved in clinical trials. So there's a lot of focus often on the clinicians, and that's fine, but there are not that many clinicians in many of the places we work in, and often it's not the clinicians that ever see the participants. So in things like maternal health, malnutrition, much of the childhood related big burdens of disease, we need to be working more with nurses, midwives, frontline healthcare workers, and we need to teach them about research and why it's important to gather data and make just thinking about research part of their normal daily processes and how it can help them improve the outcomes of the patients that they work with.
And finally, how does your research fit into translational medicine within the department?
Within this department in Oxford, we've got a huge amount of activity in tropical medicine and global health, right from the laboratory and the earliest points in the line of science, from discovering molecules and interventions through to testing the interventions in the field, then on to the public health and intervention and making sure that these changes make the biggest impact possible in health outcomes. So where we fit into that is bringing it all together really and providing a mechanism for disseminating all that progress, and also finding collaborators and making the clinical trials a reality in the field and supporting them happening and making sure they have all the tools and resources they need to do those studies.
Thank you, Trudie.